In this video, we're going to work out the limit of sine x over x. In particular, we're going to work out the limit as x approaches 0 of sine x over x. And this is both an application of what we've learned before about limits, and it's a setup for figuring out the derivatives of trig functions. So, just a recap of what we learned about limits, we have the sandwich theorem, sometimes called the squeeze theorem. So if you have three functions, and the function g of x is sandwiched between f of x and h of x. So you always have g of x is the one in the middle. It's bigger than f of x, and it's less than h of x for all points except a, all points near a except a. And if the limit of f and the limit of h are both l, then the limit of g also has to be l. And here's a picture of the theorem. We have our function f at the bottom and our function h at the top, and they both have the same limit as x approaches a. And the function g, we don't know anything about g. It could have some horrible formula where there's no hope of doing anything algebraic with it. But as long as we know that it's between f and h, then f and h are both getting closer and closer and closer and closer to l. This value is l here. And that means that g is squeezed between them or sandwiched between them and also has to be getting closer and closer and closer to l. So as an example, we're going to take the function sine x over x, and we're going to show that it's bigger than a function whose limit we can compute, and it's less than a function whose limits we can compute. And by squeezing this between those two other functions, we're going to compute this limit. So the way we do this is we look at the unit circle. So let's suppose we have a piece of the unit circle. So this distance is 1. And we'd go an angle x around the unit circle. Now, usually we use x for horizontal coordinate, but in this case, x is an angle. So if x is the angle, then the coordinates of this point are cosine x sine x. In other words, the horizontal distance is cosine x, and the vertical distance is sine x. We could also go farther out. We could take a bigger triangle whose base is 1. By similar triangles, the SOHCAHTOA says the tangent is the opposite over the adjacent. And in this case, this distance is 1, so the opposite has to be the tangent of x. So we're going to look at three regions. The first region is I'm going to call it triangle 1. It's everything inside this triangle. So it's this region. And we're going to look at the area of triangle 1. And then we're going to add a little bit more area. And this whole region here we'll call S, S for sector. It's a pie wedge. It's a piece of the whole circle. It's not cut off with a triangle. It's a piece of the whole circle with angle X. And then we're going to add a little bit more area. And we're going to get a bigger triangle, T2. And we're always going to have that the area of T1 is less than or equal to the area of the sector, because you had to add this stuff to get the area of the sector, which is less than or equal to the area of T2, because you had to add this stuff to get the area of T2. So let's see what these areas are. The triangle T1 was a triangle with a base of cosine of x and a height of sine of x. So its area is 1/2 base times height. So that's 1/2 cosine of x times sine of x. The sector, to figure out the sector, we have to say, well, this is a fraction of the whole circle. It's a fraction x over 2 pi of the whole circle. And the whole circle has area pi. So x over 2 pi times pi is x over 2. And the big triangle has a base of 1 and a height of tangent of x. So its area is 1/2 of 1 times tangent of x. In other words, 1/2 sine x over cosine x. And because the sector sits inside of the big triangle, and because the little triangle sits inside of the sector, this is less than or equal to this, which is less than or equal to this. So let's write that down. We've got 1/2 sine of x times cosine of x is less than or equal to x over 2, which is less than or equal to 1 half of sine of x divided by cosine of x. Now we're going to divide both sides by sine of x and multiply both sides by 2. All three sides. We're going to multiply through by 2, and that gets rid of this 2. Then we're going to divide by sine of x. And that's getting a little bit sloppy, so let's rewrite it all in advance. And now we've had this inequality, and this is almost what we want, except that we wanted to look at sine x over x. This is x over sine x. So we'll take the reciprocal of all these things. Now when you take a reciprocal, the reciprocal of a small number is big, and the reciprocal of a big number is small. So 1 over cosine is bigger than 1 over x over sine, in other words, sine over x, which is bigger than 1 over cosine, which is cosine. And now I'm just going to move things over. We're going to put this on the left and this on the right, and we get that the cosine is less than or equal to sine x over x, which is less than or equal to 1 over cosine. So now we can apply the squeeze theorem. This is our function f of x. This is our function g of x. This is our function h of x. And we look at what happens as x approaches 0. As x approaches 0, cosine of x approaches cosine of 0, which is 1. 1 over cosine of x approaches 1 over cosine of 0, which is 1 over 1, which is also 1. So f of x goes to 1, and h of x goes to 1. G of x is stuck in the middle. So g of x also has to go to 1. So there's our limit. Our limit's 1. But I cheated a little bit. When I drew my pictures only made sense if x was positive. You see, we talked about having this sector of size x. And so this argument is perfectly good for the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive side, but we still have to worry about what happens when x approaches 0 from the negative side. We've only done half the problem. We've shown that the one-sided limit is 1. We still have to worry about the other side. Don't worry, it works out. So if x is negative, we use the property that the sine of minus x is always minus the sine of x. Or if you prefer, you can say the sine of x is minus the sine of minus x. Divide both sides by x, and you get the sine of x over x is the sine of minus x over minus x. But if x is negative, minus x is positive. So we can draw all the pictures that we drew in the early part of this video, only with minus x instead of x, and get that cosine of minus x is less than or equal to sine of minus x over minus x is less than or equal to 1 over cosine of minus x. And then we use the fact that cosine of minus x is the same thing as cosine of x. 1 over cos minus of x equals 1 over cos x. And we already said that sine of minus x over minus x is the same thing as sine of x over x. So there we have our squeeze. This is the squeeze that we used for positive values of x. It still works for negative values of x. So in fact, it's not just a one-sided limit. No matter which direction you go, the limit as x approaches 0 of sine x over x is 1. If you plug in a tiny value of x, the numerator is small, the denominator is small, but the ratio is close to 1.